Welcome in to Homeward Bound Harmonies 4, tribute to Colloca. This is the first Homeward Bound Harmony show that has drums and electric guitars. So, and there's an example. Thank you, good night. Alright, so we're going to have mainly Beetlejuice All-Stars. There's a few rookies on the list, but they have been know them in other capacities. So along the way, to save time, I'm going to introduce them one by one whenever we're switching things around. So we'll start with the opening band. Way over here on your left on the keyboards is the virtuoso, Professor Longhair himself, Luis Brigido. You know the bar dogs and the posters up in the post office. For, you know,
don't forget the milk cartons.
Milk cartons too. This pizza man's eating the bar dogs. And he's not playing, he's singing a lot tonight. Over here has been a go-to guy for a lot of my Beetlejuice events. He has as you can tell by that rocking guitar, George Harrison's dad, and the box piece. 30, all the instruments. And he let Hilton Valentine use his guitars for when he played it. So this is from Plastic Soul out of the Utica area, Mark Barnes. That's a long drive. Here's another Beetlejuice veteran who's a Beetle buddy and a Beetle geek, just like me. And if you ever need anything instrument-wise, go to Guitar Center. He runs the joint. It's Chris Ames. And over here has been another Homeward Bound Harmonies veteran and Beetlejuice veteran, and we've seen him in his solo act, as well as sometimes in Dark Hollow. And his name is Sean Halloran. I'm ringing all day. Oh yeah, I just wanted to hear ring. Because there's ringo back here. Yeah? And the drummer from Chris Ames' band, and he's trying to make it the Dan Clausen band, but he's to no success. Dan Clausen! He's vintage London Ringo set. Not survived bloodline. Here we get now. The whole idea is that we're going to Southern California, Laurel Canyon, which is right outside of LA, up Hollywood Boulevard in the Laurel Canyon. And that's where all the musicians hung out in the 60s and 70s. This is the first kind of famous musician that moved to Laurel Canyon, as evidenced by the grand piano in the living room of his house with sand on the floor to create songs, Brian Wilson. So we're going to do some Beach Boys to bring you back to California, okay? Here we go.
Pushing on,
Things should have sounded. I want to give props to everybody that's going to be on stage tonight, today. We had probably four to five hour rehearsals on vocals alone, and one long 6.5 hour rehearsal the other night. So please give a round of applause to the tireless energy that these people put into this show. And these are hard. And like Ron Burgundy, thank you. So here's Brian Wilson's reply to a Phil Spector song.
Oh, man.
watched either Echo in the Canyon or the Laurel Canyon documentaries. Oh, good. We can do that. At least half. This is what this show is based on. Both had different takes. One forgot Joni Mitchell altogether and had the Doors. Yeah. And then the other one didn't really have love. The band.
Hi, Jenny.
Hello. Moving parts. Okay. So in both documentaries, the first band that was kind of featured in 1965 in the Little Canyon sound was the Birds. And here's a beautiful 12 string. And we're gonna have two 12 strings at one point. Here we go, here's the big hit.
Stay on, and I can feel all that better.
Good job. Sounds good.
I don't know, here's another great hit. You can see your song first.
Thank you.
That might be Mark's home. The reason why I picked that song was Roger McGuinn had the Birds and Mr. Tambourine Man, and George Harrison wrote If I Needed Someone and sent it to Roger to say, oh, that made me sound like it was fancy. So the Birds and the Beatles were going back and forth a little bit. Here's one from Beatles 65, I believe.
Stop.
Yep. Harmonies. All right, we're just some switcheroonies here, add some singers. And a bass player.
Thank you. Thank you.
No, I didn't take it. I did? I don't think I did. No, I don't think I did.
Any good time so far? Thank you, Colloca family, the Colloca family of the Colloca Winery for hosting us again, for all the hospitality. Let's put your hands together for Colloca. He's got music all year long, which is sort of rare, especially during COVID times. Thank you, Chris and Mindy.
So
this is where I kind of let Mark Ballard take charge for a couple songs. I'm going to do seminal band that birthed so many bands in Southern California. Buffalo, not Buffalo Springfield. Which you movies? Okay, so like I said, we're going to be introducing people as they make it up the stage. So over here, his first song of the day so far, joining his bandmate, the Barn Dogs. This is Mark Wester. He's ready. I love that color of his guitar. Is that Lake Placid Blue? You know him from Butternut Creek Revival, whether it be duo or full band, and a couple of DVD pieces along the way. Tone Meister, Ed Gorham.
I don't know about you guys, but I grew up to Buffalo Springfield. They broke up in 1968, and they released their greatest hits in 1969 called Retrospective. And my dad brought home an 8-track tape, and I wore it out until it broke. But not before I learned all the songs. You guys all ready?
First time for Paul Five! You usually see him on the east side of town. He never makes it up to the far northwest side of
town. It was a lovely afternoon out here. I'm not sure if you're right in Ontario. Thank you for inviting me.
For the cool drink of the year, I was chosen to sing it.
Sleeping in my eyes, never miss.
all those great people.
Thank you.
All right. You'll all be back up later because we have a whole new crew coming in. If you want to get a drink or a something to eat or use the, you know, now's the time to do it. We need about 5 minutes to set things up. We've got a special reception.